Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we will be making this cute baking scene, looking as though you just left your kitchen for a moment. I started by making the camera and light into a collection, then hiding them. Delete the default cube. Add a cylinder and rotate it 90 degrees on the x-axis. In edit mode, add a loop cut in the middle and delete the vertices on the right side. Apply all transforms and add the mirror modifier. Select the outside face and extend the cylinder. Scale it down. Selecting the same outside face, inset it. With the inset selected, extrude, then extrude again. Scale the face to be wider and then extrude again and scale the face to be smaller. Use Ctrl 2 to subdivide. Make a loop cut and slide it down to the end of the rolling pin. Add more subdivision and shade smooth. Add a loop cut towards the bottom of the handle to make it sharper. Hide the rolling pin and add a plane. Add subdivision and then subdivide the plane to add more faces. Using the vertices selection mode, pull and move the vertices to get a natural rolled dough look. Use mine for a reference or experiment with the shape. When you're happy with the shape, extrude it to add thickness, then add a loop cut around the edge. Add more subdivision and shade smooth. Add a cube and scale it down along the z-axis to make it flat. In edit mode, select an outside face to make it a longer rectangle. Add subdivision and then a bevel modifier. Add a loop cut along the width and then loop cuts to the edges. Don't forget to shade smooth. Add a cube, this will be our bowl. Select the bottom face and scale it to be more narrow. Select the top face and inset it. Extrude the selection to make the inside of the bowl. Add subdivision. Add a loop cut to the top of the bowl to make the lip thicker. Add more subdivision and shade smooth. Select the bottom face and inset it along with the inside of the bowl. Select the edges of the inside of the bowl and duplicate it. Then make it separate using P. Select all using A and then F to fill. Add a displace modifier and then add a new texture. Go into the texture properties and change the type to clouds. Go into edit mode and subdivide the circle. This lets us have a smoother displace. You can experiment to get many different textures, but I was trying to make it look like a bowl of flour. The edges were sticking out, so I selected the vertices and deleted them. Then I parented the flour to the bowl. Add a circle and make the vertices 10. Select all and fill. With the knife tool, make a cut down the middle and delete the right side. Apply all transforms and add a mirror modifier. Selecting the edge, extrude and scale down. Select the two vertices at the point and click M to merge. Apply the mirror modifier and add subdivision. Select all, then extrude. Add a loop cut on the side to give thickness. Shade smooth and add more subdivision. I made some adjustments to the shape. Add another circle and use the knife tool to make a cut down the middle. Delete the right side. Apply all transforms and add the mirror modifier. Select one of the side edges and extrude. Select the bottom edge on the extrusion and extrude again. Then add subdivision. In edit mode, I move vertices around to get the shape I was looking for. Just a reminder, you can make any animal you want by following these steps. You can scale vertices as well as edges and faces. Apply the modifier and shade smooth. Select all and extrude. Add a loop cut to the side to give thickness. In edit mode, select the edges using Shift-Alt. Then duplicate and separate into a new layer. Repeat this for the other animal. These will be our cookie cutters. Hide the cookies and focus on the cutters. Add a solidify modifier to give some thickness. Select the object without the modifier, then the one with the modifier. In the dropdown, choose copy to selected. Add more subdivision to make them smoother. Add a cylinder and scale it down. Select the top face and slide it up to be longer. With the top face still selected, duplicate it and separate. Extrude the same face. Scale it down a bit, then inset the top face. With the faces still selected, extrude them up. Duplicate the object and scale it down. Delete the following faces. Select the inside edges using Alt and scale to make the cutout bigger. With the edges selected, extrude them up. Please ignore the top for now since I fix this soon. With the cylinder, add a loop cut to the top and to the bottom. Bevel the top loop cut, along with the bottom loop cut. Select the bottom face and inset it. Select the bottom cap's edges using X-ray, then bevel them. Add another cut with scroll wheel to have a cut in the middle. Using Alt-E, extrude faces along normals and pull them in slightly. Add a bevel modifier. Give the bevel two segments and then shade smooth. Where the cap meets the lid, add two loop cuts. Select the two loops, then extrude along normals to move them in slightly. For the lid, add a cylinder and scale it down to fit on top of the cap. Delete the top face and scale inward to make a point. Slide up to be longer. Add a solidify modifier to add some thickness. Add subdivision, then add a loop cut and slide it to the bottom. Make sure your subdivision is the top modifier. Inset the bottom face and use shade auto smooth. Just like the cap, we will be doing the same for the lid. Bevel the edges and extrude along normals to set in slightly. Add a bevel modifier and subdivision. Select all objects with the main bottle last, then parent. Now we will be setting up the scene. Unhide all of your objects and scale them down. I made sure all objects were parallel to the y-axis. Be creative and change whatever you'd like. When you add your cookies to the board, make sure they have even thickness. To make cookie cutouts, duplicate one of your cookies and lay it on top of the dough. Make sure the cookie is thick enough. If it's too thin, the cut may look odd. Add a Boolean modifier to the dough. With the Object Eyedropper tool, select the cookie on the dough. Hide that cookie and then you should see the result. Add a bevel modifier to help with the smoothness. Repeat the same process with every cookie. Remember to keep adding their own Booleans to the dough. I will be doing 6 cookies in total. If the Boolean is not working, try applying all transforms to the dough. Thank you. I made this cookie thicker because it wasn't cutting through the dough. I had to add more subdivision to make the dough smoother. Add a plane and scale it out for our scene. Select three edges and extrude them up. Add a plane and scale it down in front of the first cookie. Extrude it and inset it, sliding the face up a bit. Add subdivision and shade smooth. Duplicate it for the other eye. Add a path and scale it down on the first cookie. This will be our mouth. Selecting the first vertices, middle and last, slide them up. Subdivide the path and make adjustments. In the curve properties, add depth. Selecting the first and last vertices, you can use Alt-S to scale them down. Duplicate the eye to use for the nose. Make adjustments to the nose using scale. Duplicate the eyes, nose, and mouth and place them on the other cookie. Add a plane and scale it down on top of the first cookie's ear. In edit mode, select the top vertices and scale them down for the ear shape. Add subdivision and extrude, then shade smooth. Duplicate for the other ear. For the other cookie, add a plane and scale it down to the ear. Use subdivision and match the ear shape of your other cookie. Scale the edges or add another loop cut to make the shape. Extrude to add thickness. Duplicate to the other ear. Add a plane and tuck it underneath the board. Extrude and inset. With inset selected, extrude down slightly. Add subdivision, then add a loop cut on the top and the bottom. Add another loop cut along the side. Go into the shading editor and start adding materials to your objects. I made a metallic material for the cookie cutters. Have fun with the materials. This is your chance to really showcase your style. Selecting parts of the bottle, you can use the plus and minus sign on your keyboard to select more or less. This will stay within the single object instead of selecting the whole bottle. Now we will be using nodes for the cookie texture. Add a bump, noise texture, then mapping and texture coordinate. Connect every node as followed. Play around with the values. You can get many different results this way. I like to split my screens so I can edit my camera view. Add your camera and on the left panel, make the viewport active camera. Make the camera orthographic and position it. Change the left panel view into render. Start adding lights. I used area lights for this scene. In render properties, change the engine to cycles and device to GPU. In render, I change my samples to 1000. In output properties, under color management, I made the view transform filmic and the look to high contrast. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you were able to follow along or even learn something new.